Sarah Silverman and Seth Rogen have proceeded to get on social media and call everyone that doesn't like their movie a white supremacist, because that's the type of people we're dealing with.
Now, in fairness to Jeremy, this was originally about the other Jeremy, and that was even more embarrassing because the Quartering, at least, did try to verify Santa Inc. was bombarded by a bunch of far-right anti-Semites and neo-Nazis, and to his credit, he agreed, okay, some of the comments were a little out there, but being the Quartering, he's still blaming Seth Rogen. But then the other Jeremy drops a video, and as usual, Geeks and Gamers has gotten really, really lazy. They don't even bother to do any research, so he just goes in and says, well, it's gotten a lot of downvotes. I trust the downvotes. I don't trust Seth Rogen. They're calling ists and foes, but there's nothing there. And we're going to hear him make a complete fool of himself because, on the contrary, there is evidence that something funny is going on.
But this is current Hollywood. This is Hollywood trying to push their nonsense into something, and then when you reject that something, you're the racist and the sexist, apparently. What's the latest on the Santa Inc. trailer? The latest is 133,000. 133,000 downvotes to only 3,500 upvotes. And those 3,500 upvotes basically just happen because there's a lot of people that just like stuff and don't even think about it. 133, plus the comment section completely turned off. A complete and total disaster on every single level.
Well, two things to say. One is that even in the comment section of this very video, some people are making borderline remarks. The fairest you could say are very borderline remarks that are very close to racism and anti-Semitism. In terms of Santa Inc. itself, no, it's been documented. And the comments are pretty shockingly explicit, and they're very, very clear about what they mean. Now, it could be, and this is me being logical, Santa Inc. is not a good program. It's not a good series. I myself am not a big Seth Rogen fan. I think he's fine, but the only thing I like by him really is Pineapple Express. But he's okay. Sarah Silverman is very talented, but even she puts out some weak material. So I don't expect Santa Inc. itself to actually be all that good, but it is what it is. Unfortunately, a lot of these neo-Nazis just took advantage of the situation. These are two Jewish performers, and they basically got into the action. It may be true, because the comments in other places are very harsh, but they're not necessarily, they're not Nazis, they're not anti-Semites, they just don't like Seth Rogen. So it is a mixture, but no, those comments did show up. Unfortunately, because the original page is gone, we have to go back and reconstruct, so it's very hard to estimate. But even if it's only a small minority, Jeremy's just lying. No, some of these comments were what they were. Seth Rogen is right. Now, were all the negative comments by quote-unquote fans of the H-Man? No, not necessarily, but it's more than a few. It wasn't just a very small group. These are at least hundreds of people who posted comments, and they've even put up YouTube pages proudly saying, yes, that's what we did. And here are these quotes, and here are these tweets, and here are these comments from the original page, and they're proud of themselves. They fully identify with that ideology. So it's a disturbing situation, and as always, Jeremiah has, and I'll be nice, he's accidentally co-signed, but he has done it. He just stupidly defended these people, didn't bother to differentiate. He says, all you good people, I encourage you. And in his own comment section, they're clearly not just complaining about the quality of the show. They are attacking them on a racial and religious basis. The best I can do for Jeremy is he's not himself full-blown alt-right, but he is, yes, he is covering for them. Whether he's doing it just being lazy, he has to take responsibility for that. It is his channel, it is his business, and he is, again, sanctioning it because he's just not doing his homework. And that's his problem. But if he wants to associate with neo-Nazis, that's his business. But if he wants to not get called out for it, here's a clue. Do some research, mind your language, and actually know what the hell you're talking about before you speak. That's my advice.